In this video, we talk about the fun of traveling in an RV with your dog.
And we're also going to talk about the frustrations of traveling in an RV with your dog.
And we'll show you the way we manage our travels with Bo.
So we love traveling with Bo as we go across the country, and he loves visiting new places and rolling around on the grass.
Lots of new friends to be made.
Yeah, but traveling with a dog in an RV can be quite the challenge. And in this video, we're going to show you what apps we use, what products we use that make it a little better. And we also want to remind you that we have a free guide about RVing with dogs. That it's absolutely free. I'll put a link in the description where you can go and download that for absolutely nothing. It's absolutely free and it will help you with lots of resources. So come on along. We'll show you what it's like with Bo. We have a lot of fun with him.
We certainly do. Besides the joy of traveling with a dog, it also presents a lot of problems. It's just hard to take care of all their needs, and when you travel with a dog, the national parks are not dog friendly. It becomes a real obstacle. And often because of heat or weather conditions, you just have to always think about their needs, what they need.
So let's talk about the first challenge. When you have to leave your dog in your RV. As Jennifer says, the weather conditions, heat, too much cold, too much heat, can present a problem to a dog in an RV. You worry about what happens if it gets too hot or too cold in there. Well, we have found a solution to that, and it's a piece of technology that works with our smartphone and gives us true peace of mind. It's called the RV Pet Safety App. And this app works with a device that we mount inside the RV. That device in turn uses a cellular connection to constantly give you access to read the temperature inside your RV. You can set it to certain alerts. For example, I set ours, if it's 95 degrees inside the RV, it will send me an immediate text. So I know that something's not right, the air conditioner's not working, or there's too much sun, it heated up. I also have it set for really frigid temperatures as well, but mostly it's heat. And this gives us great freedom to go out to dinner, to go to restaurants, to do some shopping, to take a hike, knowing that with my smartphone, I'm gonna get an alert if it gets too hot in there. And of course, we can check it anytime we want. And that's really a big comfort when you're leaving a dog in an RV for a little while. So I want to show you how it works. You install the pet monitor, like you saw where we put it on ours, where the dog is. It's got a little peel and stick mounting bracket. Then you download and use the app. Now, see the buy now thing? Don't buy yet. I just want to show you something. You have to choose your plan. They have two of them. One of them is the light plan, and this is for those of you who don't travel all the time. You can buy it as you go. It's $19.99 a month. You still have to buy the device here, but the cellular access is only the month that you activate it in. Now, we travel all the time, 3/4 of the time, so we travel all 12 months. So for us, we get the digital nomad plan, which is a yearly plan. And instead of $19.99 a month, we can get our cellular access for $10 a month. And it works on the Verizon 4G network, goes wherever Verizon is, and it's free shipping, all that stuff below. Now, they will give you a coupon for 40% off, but don't do that. You can see it's normally $3.19. With their coupon, it's $2.79. I'm going to put this on the cart here. Add it to the cart right here. I want to just show you something. And there it is, and you can see their pricing.
with their whole deal is 319. That's with their 40%. But they have arranged with you for as a viewer of the RV Lifestyle Channel, a special coupon. So you hit, see this down here? Apply coupon. You hit that, and in that you simply type in RV Lifestyle. Okay. Now watch what happens. You get $100 off using the coupon RV Lifestyle right here. See that? $100 off. So the price to you is under the special deal they gave us is just $219. So that's a pretty reasonable fee. That's the device and a year's worth of service.
There are times when you just have to make arrangements for your pet. You have something you have to do where you just can't include them and you don't want to leave them. And that's when we use a pet service called Rover. It's kind of like having family that you can leave your pet with. You feel secure, you leave them, you know they're going to be well taken care of. They send you a picture of your pet every day if you leave for an extended period of time. You just feel comfortable leaving your pet in their care. We have used it all across the country, and not only us, but Bo couldn't be happier.
Let me show you how Rover works. You can access it through your app on your smartphone or through the website, rover.com. I'll put a link in the description below. But as you can see, it automatically recognizes my account, welcomes me back. And you can see on the left here, right here, are some of the previous dog sitters that we've had. And they're great. These people have been just awesome. They have a number of different categories. You can go dog boarding. You can do house sitting, drop-in visits where the Rover person will come into your home or your RV and check them out. Some of them are just doggy daycare. Maybe you need to just drop them off for a day so you can go on a hike or take in an event. And others will come and actually dog walk. We've used people who've come to the campsite, picked up Bo and taken him to their house for a day and then brought him back at night. It's pretty simple. You start with the dates and they ask you, you know, where do you want to go? And for example, let's say the next trip we're taking is to Perry, Georgia. And it dropped down and when do I want to drop him off? Well, I want to drop him off on the 30th, which is a Friday. I want to pick him up on the 31st, Saturday. And then it just says search. And there you go. You can see it's already confirmed the availability on those times. And it'll enlist some of the people in the area. You can read their reviews. And that's a big help. We always like to read the reviews. And if you check the reviews, you'll see the people who've dropped their dogs off like them. And this is a guy who's got some great reviews. But there's a whole bunch of them there that you can choose from. And once you have found the one that you like, you simply contact them and ask them if they'll watch your dog. There's a little bio that you can get on all of them, and that always helps. For example, we're going to look at Erica here, who is not too far. And there's a profile of Erica. There's some photos. There's her rates per night to do house sitting at your place or in her house, $35 a night, which is pretty reasonable. And she talks a little bit about herself. She's owned dogs and cats. She lives in a house, non-smoking. She's got some kids there, has a fenced yard, no dogs that she owns. And I can see her dates of availability right there. And then I would just hit contact to make the booking. And you also get a map of the general area that you've searched, and you can see where everybody lives so you can find out where you are and how far the sitter is from you. Rover.com, again, we'll put a link in the description. We have used it. They have sent us photographs of Bo many times. It's been an awesome experience, and I highly recommend it. We'll put a link how you can sign up by just going to their website.
A big part of our day when we travel with Bo is finding a dog park where he can go off leash. This happens to be the one in Fort Walton Beach, Florida. And it's one of Bo's favorite places because it's actually on the water. There's a big fenced in area here where he can get lots of exercise. And usually there's other dogs here that he plays with. We bring Bo to a dog park as we travel across the country. We use a couple of apps, and I'll show you those apps to help us find them. And that really gets him a little exercise, and then it helps us stretch our legs as we're traveling too. We found that dog parks are just a great way to meet people and understand what's going on and in an area. And of course, it keeps Bo from having too much energy. He gets to get rid of some of his energy.
It's really hard to find a place where you can let your dog run free on the beach, and they want to be on the beach too, just like you do. And this is just a delightful place. The dogs can run, interact, play. It's shallow sand, and the dogs really have fun here.
Let me show you another resource that we rely on a lot. It's called bringfido.com. It's a website, and it lists hotels, restaurants, and all sorts of places. Now, here's the secret. We don't need a hotel because we're in an RV. But if I drop it down, you can see restaurants, activities, events, services. You can have people take pictures of your dog. But go to activities. That's what we do. We start with activities. And then I'm going to type in our destination now, where we are right now. We're in Fort Walton Beach, Florida. And bingo, dog-friendly activities. Liza Jackson Dog Park. And that's an awesome place. That's the one that we just showed you. And there's a map on how to get there. They have a website that you can go on and learn more. A description is divided into small and large dog parks. There's a hose station to get salt water off the dog. They have water fountains. There's good reviews there. And of course, it has a dog beach. Now, if you're looking to find a place where you can bring your dog to eat, and lots of places you can. Here's one of our favorite restaurants, Hammerhead's Bar and Grill. And there's some photos of it. You see it has an outdoor eating area. And there's what it looks like at night. It's kind of a little ambiance there. It's right near the harbor in Destin. Now there's what their food looks like. And the nice thing is that you can bring your dog. So Bring Fido is the website, and we use that. Any city we're in, that's probably the first thing we do when we know we're going to stay for a while is we check out where we can take Bo for his exercise and find an off-leash dog park or a beach and restaurants where we can take Bo.
I want to show you a package that we picked up from our friends at Mighty Paws, which solve a lot of our problems that we have with Bo. Mighty Paws makes the ultimate travel package for dogs. Three things that you need.
The first thing is a long lead, and this leash made out of a cloth material, it doesn't scratch, is 30 feet long. It's great when we're boondocking, I can hook it up to Bo, and I know that he's got some room to move around and not feel like he's constrained to just this little tiny area. A long lead, that's pretty cool. The 30-foot one is the one we have.
This is the second item. It's a safety harness that we could use to walk him when we want to take him out, or we can use it in the vehicle to keep him secure. You can use to hook him up to a seat belt in the vehicle, and there's also one in the front as well. Just as you wear a seat belt, we want to keep our pet safe as well.
This little strap here from Mighty Paws works with that harness to keep him connected. This part connects to the harness that he wears, and this little part with like a little carabiner, this will go right around where you have the seat belt fastened in, where it connects to the floor. So this gives him some room, and it keeps him safe when it's connected to that harness, and it's very easy to get off when you want to take him out of the vehicle.
This system from Mighty Paws is easy to connect to Bo and to our seat belt, and will keep Bo safe. Don't forget, we have a free guide that'll help you travel with your dog.
We'll put a link to that and to all the products and the apps we just showed you in the description below this video. Meantime, please do us a favor, subscribe to the RV Lifestyle channel right here on YouTube. We're Mike and Jennifer Wendland. Thank you for watching.
Happy trails.